10 Investment Strategies by Peter Lynch. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to David Dodge. Peter Lynch is the former manager of Magellan Fund, who is now in charge of investments. Over the years, Lynch has proven his knowledge and techniques in the stock market. He's seen huge improvements in stocks he authorized the purchasing of, and if there's anyone whose advice will truly be useful to another interested in doing the same work he did, it's his. In this video, we have compiled 10 of Lynch's strategies to a good investment. Number 1. Say no to hottest stock company. According to Lynch, while the hottest stocks may seem appealing upon first glance, they usually spell for disaster in the near future. Usually how it goes is in the beginning when the stock is doing great, it will receive a lot of publicity and people will start investing in it. Soon enough, these same people will realize that they maybe don't have enough money to continue investing and will back off. Just like any other popular product, copies will be made once the success is advertised and people will cash into other versions of their cheaper prices. Then the stock price will fall and your investment will hit the bottom. Number 2. Homework. One of Lynch's rules when one wants to begin investing is to learn the basics of how everything works so you know exactly what you're getting yourself into. There are books out there to educate those willing to be educated, and he himself has written on two, which should be a necessary read in every adult's life. His book explains the ins and outs of the business world and how to protect your money when trying to double or triple it. Number 3. Understand. This may seem like common knowledge, but you'd be surprised at how many people jump at the chance to invest when they hear something's shares are increasing in price, but don't even know what the share is for. Lynch believes you must only put money in things you understand. So when sudden changes occur, you're able to adapt to best serve your own interests. For example, if you have studied about biotech companies and consider yourself an expert on them, go ahead and invest. However, if you don't know a thing about them or haven't studied how they work, according to Lynch, you should refrain. Number 4. Long term. We tend to get excited about buying stocks, especially when they increase and we want to make as much money as we can on them. Lynch has a theory in which he states that we need to focus on the long-term effects of any investments we make. Not only will this limit the number of rash decisions we make in the heat of the moment, but it will also save us thousands of dollars. Instead of investing large amounts immediately, try going slower and buying steadily at a more affordable pace. Number 5. Diversify. The reason Lynch has had such a success investing all his life is that he has dipped into all types of markets. He's invested in firms of different products, markets, and sizes. He thinks we need to spread our money out so that if something sudden occurs, we have multiple different investments to fall back on. Although diversification is a good idea, he's worried about people investing randomly for the sake of diversifying, which is a bad idea. Only do so if you can find a valuable enough stock. Number 6. Patience. Lynch has said this again and again, but wait it out. Don't expect stocks to bring you insane revenues weeks or even months after you purchase them. You will know the true value of your investment will take 3 to 10 years to become visible, and until then, you're going to have to wait. Sure, there can be sudden spikes or downfalls during those years, but the larger picture will take a decade to come together, so don't be hasty. Number 7. Corrections. When you own big company stocks, it would do you well not to fret over the market cycle. Recessions and booms are usually difficult to predict and come and go quickly. So while you'll be waiting to sell or buy stocks to make a buck, it may backfire on you. The economy is volatile, and in that past, people have lost more money trying to change their stock numbers when they anticipated a rise or fall in the economy than they have due to the actual cycle. In the end, Just try to aim towards a profit when the market is fully recovered and running smoothly. Number 8. Right and wrong. If you've been corrected multiple times about a stock price going up or down, good for you. This does not, however, mean that you will always be right or that the market can be molded in any way you say. Always be cautious. Number 9. Time will tell. When you're buying stocks of large-scale firms, you're thinking of the future. These businesses usually grow stronger as the years go on and, unlike smaller companies, will change more steadily. Number 10. Don't get scared. If you've made a mistake or your judgment has been wrong, that's okay. Don't let this fear make you stop completely because you can never succeed if you stop trying. If one bad investment lost you money, you may not lose more, but you're out of chances to potentially win that money back. So when you fall down, just get back up. This brings us to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hit like if you did and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss any of our videos in the future. Also, watch the two videos that are on your screen because I'm sure you'll love them. With that, I'll see you in the next video.